Hey guys, Professor Fat Shady, University of Trials. This time doing a bit of a revisit of the Top Roach Challenge, which is to complete a zero fault run using the Roach of the Rock of Rages track. Now this challenge is brutally hard. I've had a stack of people, I made a video about this a little while back, pretty much soon after I started making Trials Fusion content, and yeah, I failed miserably. I've spent a bit of time practicing. I've also received a bunch of requests from people asking me to revisit this one, so I wanted to sort of blast through this now. This is the challenge. It's hard. Funnily enough, I actually just sat here and recorded for about half an hour without actually pressing start on my capture card. So you may find when I first started this, so the first time I did it, I did this challenge, like so first time tonight I did it. Did it in about 40 something faults. The next time I did it, it was 20 something. The next time I did it was about 10, I think 9. The next time I did it was 4. And this is effectively my next run after that, and that would have been 2, but I stuffed it because this jump is a nightmare. So there you go, guys. And don't worry, that's not the tutorial, that's just me screwing around. That's Rock of Rages, Top Roach in like 3 faults. But now I want to go through and do a bit of a tutorial. I want to break down the techniques that I'm using. Look, you can see there, if I can do that in 3 faults, and I can do that, I won't say consistently, but regularly enough, to me now, I know the track so well, I know the technique so well, it's just a matter of stringing them all together in one lucky run. I don't think I've even got the skills to be able to consistently nail this, but I've got enough to be able to get through it. It's just a matter of repetition. I will just do this 100,000 more times, and eventually it will all just click and all of the pieces will fit into place. For you guys, I want to get you to that point at least. I can't teach you how to get this and guarantee that you'll get it, but what I can try and do is get you to the point where it's so second nature you'll be able to just blast through the track and eventually it will just happen. First tip, and that did take me 2 minutes, so apologies to get to the first tip. Anyway, you'll know by now that's my style. What I wanted to show you firstly, so similar to the way I did the Inferno 4 first jump, what you want to do here is actually just lift your front wheel up, flick your body weight over it. That just gives you a little bit of extra height to get up and over this first obstacle. A bounce there, you will notice this angled piece on this rock here is pretty forgiving, to be honest, so this obstacle here shouldn't be difficult to get over. This one, bit of a bounce, and just make sure you tap your brake and don't hit your head on that thing in front. This one here can be tough if you're not careful. You'll get cheap faults here. What I would suggest you do is lean forward. The key part is don't do that. The key part is, you see this little, where my front wheel's rubbing right now, there's this little, I guess you'd call it a concave piece. You want to hit your back wheel in there, but you actually want to be at a very, very full-on angle to get your wheel up and over. What tends to happen, if you go like that, your wheel gets stuck, your body, you know, the bike gets stuck, and you'll just fall. What you want to do is very sharp, and very hard and deliberate push of that rear wheel into that concave section. You're good and you're over. This, just accelerate, bit of a bunny hop, and I would suggest you go all the way up here. The key part for me is to get height off that jump. If you can, transition from a big, a nice high jump over that, bounce straight off here and onto the next few ledges. I find that easier because the more speed you carry through here, the easier the next jump is. However, if you get stuck here, the key part is nice big bunny hop, but at each time there's a little technique that I do where I drop the wheel. I drop the wheel down, so as I'm in air, drop down and then sit into it, and what that does is just gets the rear wheel in contact a little bit earlier and gets you a little bit more grip and a little bit more traction up the thing. So, and then what you want to do is jam that rear wheel into the wall and just let your body weight carry over. It just takes practice, but it's about getting that rear wheel jammed hard into the vertical ledge, but being at the right angle so your body weight carries you over. This part here I find pretty straightforward. The technique I use is I get my bike to about halfway here. I press left on the analog stick to lift the front wheel up, and I kind of want my front wheel to match the angle of that platform, and then transition into a forward leaning position. So I'll do that again. kind of gets you here. I'm just resting on the bike. Transition up, and then just jam your back wheel down, and then just slowly over that ledge, you'll make the next checkpoint. This one I find massively important, because this is one of the two or three really, really hard jumps in this challenge. What I would suggest you do is try and get yourself up onto that ledge without faulting. Get yourself up here, and then from here, actually accelerate and jump all the way over. So I'm going to try it now, see how this works. So over there, carry your weight forward, big spring jump, and again, if you get that angle right, you'll be able to dig your rear wheel in, body weight will carry over, and you'll get up and over that thing in one smooth motion. That is the best way to carry your momentum through. However, if you don't want to do that, if you want to try and find it a bit more consistent, you can try and do a little jump off here, same type of technique, jam that rear wheel in, but I really find that first technique I showed you will tend to yield more consistent results, just because you're carrying a little bit of extra weight. But there you go. A little bit of extra momentum, I should say. This one, don't neglect that jump. It's pretty straightforward. If you can make it to here, you can do that jump, but don't neglect it, and don't take too little speed through. You've got to be going fast enough to make that jump, because I've had some really annoying cheap faults there. This one, I would say, is easily the hardest obstacle in the game. In this track, on this bike in particular. You should know how to do this by now. If you're attempting this on the Roach, the way I do it is try and get the rear wheel toward the back. Rear wheel toward the bottom of it. And then if you don't know that technique there, where you're kind of holding accelerate and tapping brake, learn it, because it will help you a great deal, especially on an obstacle like this. I break this down into two separate parts. The first one is to try and get my rear wheel to hit the vertical ledge. So I just do a normal sized bunny hop, doesn't have to be massive. Yeah, so I do it in two parts. I land, and then I just kind of just ease off the accelerator as I'm halfway up that ledge. I'm going to try and get back down here. I've tried to explain this before, and it's a really tough technique. As you're halfway up this ledge, and your rear wheel starts hitting that the vertical piece, I kind of just ease off the accelerator a bit, and let your sort of natural momentum transfer you up and over on top of this. If you hold flat out, so if you hit the bottom angled platform and you just hold the accelerator at 100%, your rear wheel catches this vertical box that I'm sitting on now, and it will actually make you do a backflip and throw you off. So what I try and do is, just at the point where my rear wheel hits it, just ease off the throttle a little bit. It will still give you a little bit of full upward lift, but it doesn't give you all of the forward momentum, which is likely to throw you off the bike. From here, pretty straightforward bunny hop. But again, make sure you carry the speed through, get your angles right. You shouldn't need much in the way of tutorial, and we're over. So there we have for 33 faults. That's it for a tutorial of sorts. Now, let's just have a run at this a few times. See if you can pick up anything. I mean, look, I'm probably going to talk, but I think the more important thing is for you guys to just watch and see if you pick up any tips. It's just annoying. That's what I tend to find. I'm not sure if I said it in this video. I don't think I have yet. Because like I say, second time doing this tonight. Because I forgot to press restart. Celebrate your small victories, guys. I would always suggest, if you get one fault less than what you had in the previous attempt, you should finish the run. And that will maximize the practice you get on this track. But be happy with it. If you're at 39 faults and you get a 37 fault run, you should be stoked. Like, take that as the victory that it is. I know it's not zero fault yet, but you celebrate them. Finish the runs. You know, it's all practice, and it's all helping you towards the ultimate goal, which is getting zero fault. Which even now, I've got twos and threes a number of times. I still don't like my chances. Oh, this one, that is a brutal checkpoint. just for that reason, you get your front wheel caught up. I hate this. Wish I could find a consistent way to do this. Oh, is that there? I wonder. If anyone's got a more consistent way to do that, let me know. Like, I really want this channel to be as much about other community members helping other community members than just me blabbering on and failing. Alright, so we're 5 faults. Celebrate the victory, Fat Shady. Celebrate it, damn it. There you go, nice big height there. Stuff that up. Yes! Like, I would absolutely love for me to be able to record my Rock of Rages Zero Fault Run, Top Roach, whatever we call this damn thing. That's never gonna happen. All you're gonna get is stupid faults. Actually, the one thing I will say is, places like this, if you decide the more consistent way for you is to not stop here, don't bother practice. Well, sorry, I was going to say don't bother practicing this. There's limited benefit of you practicing that jump, but it is worthwhile for you to practice the rest of the tracks. There's this, look at this, every single damn time. I really want to sit here and just figure out a way, because getting to here isn't tough. If I could figure out a consistent way to do that, like actually from here, I would be a legend, I reckon. It's one of these things, it exists, someone out there knows it, they're not helping me tonight. So smooth in the end. But honestly, guys, you get to a point where you can do this in 5, 6, 7, 9, 10 faults, whatever, and then it's not about, like, you know the techniques, it's just about doing them more consistently and with, you know, less faults, and eventually it'll just click. See, look at that, see how much. Oh, that was horrible. But, again, just through that repetition, I'm able to figure out ways now to sort of catch and save some of these things as well. The other thing that I stopped doing was playing this track on the Pit Viper at all, like, until I'm done with this. Oh, wrong angle. Stupid challenge. And see, I could and probably should be upset with 2 faults, but it's not what it's about. It's, you know, 0 is what you're going for, but take that for what it is. If you can get, you know, I mean, like, again, I mean, this is kind of, I guess, the way I deal with, you know, those kind of situations mentally. I look at the positive. You try and be an optimist about it. Look at the positives from that and say, look, I can achieve it in 10 faults, which means I can achieve it in 8. Maybe 0 is out of your reach so far. You know, for me, I'm like, yeah, look, I can get it in 2, so 0 is within my grasp. That gives me the motivation to keep going. But I'll say this 100 times over, and you see, I'm still making cheap mistakes here, guys. You know, I'm far from perfect at this. Suck at that sometimes. But it's about finding a way that is consistent for you. Break it down into its individual components. Don't look at the zero fault challenge until you're consistently getting 5 faults. Right? As hard as that is to say, it isn't, you know, it's not something you should just instantly go for. It's a different, but a, I think almost an easier way to do that. The first bit, yeah, take your pick. A couple of different ways I approach it. Oh, that one's brutal. Yeah, I always get really cheap faults on this obstacle. Like that. Didn't even bother bunny hopping there. Ah, this is woeful. It's funny, I've made a video like this before where I tried to go over this and I sat here for like half an hour and recorded every single attempt, and in the end it was I was just broken and defeated. Like, it really, I ended up not publishing it just because it was just depressing. Like, I was gonna have to put some like suicide prevention phone numbers at the bottom of the video because I was gonna help myself. It was horrible. So yeah, look, that was 7 faults. So again, I'm not, like, for me, I'm not unhappy with 7 faults. Because I know that it's, you know, it's one, you know, cliche and all, but it's one step closer to what I'm trying to achieve. I already had a fault, so it wouldn't matter. Oh, I just can't rotate the bike enough sometimes. It's definitely the problem. Like, this bike just doesn't have that. Like, to be able to pull off a sort of, you know, kick-ass bunny hop and then manage to get the bike around just doesn't like you sometimes. Oh, this challenge is brutal. This is the thing, I don't even know what this video is about now. Like, am I giving you a tutorial? Am I just sharing my frustration? You know, does this make it a bad video because the tutorial sucked and I can't get the challenge? Or is it a good video because it you know, reassures people that, you know, it is just freaking hard? And come on, see, I usually hit that one like 2 or 3 times and I'm just like, no. Okay, come on. Actually, you know what? Here's the other bit of advice. I end up getting to a point, and I mean, it's 12:30 now. I've got to be up for work in the morning. I get to a point where I just feel my energy and I guess my mental calmness has pretty much been exhausted. And when that happens, go to bed, come back and do it again tomorrow. So yeah, don't be afraid to walk away from this thing too. Don't let it get the best of you. Even though you don't want it to, it will get the best of you on a number of occasions. And the people that get this challenge are the ones that can keep coming back for more. I want 2 faults. God, I hate this obstacle. Five. It's a bunch under 10. Like, it's not, you know. Yeah. I gotta say, I'll put this video out. It frustrates me that I can't get it. I'd love to be sitting here recording it one night, just casually chatting away and nail this thing. It's probably not gonna happen, but I wanna put this one out. It's not as suicide-y, so it's good. But I think it's important, I guess, for people to just understand Yeah, maybe I've shared some pointers about the way to approach an obstacle that you hadn't seen. Maybe I'll give you some guidance on the mental aspect of this, because I mean, this is a brutally hard challenge and is absolutely as much about your mental state and approach than it is about, you know, how your thumbs work. I'm fine. But Fat Genie, I thought you said be calm. Yeah, it doesn't happen with this challenge. Stupid redlings. Bunch of jerks. None of them will be watching this, so I could say that. I was happy. I got to go to Helsinki. I met the developers. I got to find the guy who built the extreme tracks and told him in no uncertain terms what I felt. He knows who he is. By the way, I said I love the tracks, but you're an evil, sadistic bastard and I never want to see you again. Something to that effect. A few more curses. Funny, as close as I am to getting this challenge, I really think this is the type of thing that I'll get. It'll be months before I get it. Like, I'll fluke it while making a video, or I'll just leave it. I'll just park it, and one day someone will call me up for not having it, and I'll go back and get it in a couple of hours, or something like that. But yeah, I'm getting tired. Freaking challenge. During tonight, I did this in two faults. It can't be that much harder. Hate this. But honestly, guys, you start getting to this point. I'm taking one for the team here. I'm pushing past my natural tendency to walk away. Start getting to this point, your frustration will make this so much worse. You'll make silly mistakes like that, and it's just not worth it. Honestly, come back the next day, and that'd be my approach with this. If you are dead keen on doing this, if this is like, you know, your last challenge, I got so many challenges left to do, it's not funny. But if this is your last one, right, and you're like, I need to get this or my life won't be complete, I would suggest maybe half an hour a day. You know, load up your Xbox, chuck it in for half an hour, have a crack at it, you know, get a few good runs out, get some practice in, go and play some FIFA, go and play, whatever, I'm not getting paid for these, I can say what I want. Go and play some FIFA, go and play, you know, whatever the hell you're playing at the moment, right? Do that for your own mental well-being. Come back to it, try it again. Celebrate your victories, enjoy, you know, decreasing your best by one fault should be an awesome celebration, right? You do that enough times, eventually you'll be back here, and gradually the twos will become ones, will become zeros, and next thing you know, you'll be telling me how to make this video. God, I hate this. But that was it, so I've kind of peaked for tonight, I think. I could sit here for another hour and never get a two-fault run again. So I think I'm going to call this quits. I'm going to publish a depressing, another unsuccessful video of this. And I'll get these lovely people. Hopefully none of them watch the end of this. Every now and again I always get someone going, oh, I did this ages ago. I did this in, you know, I did this in April. What are you doing? Yeah, thanks, dude. The rest of us have, I don't know. I don't want to imply anything about people that have or don't have lives. I sit here and make videos in my spare time. Clearly, my life can't be that full on. But yes, you can see this is just tapering off into a very much a non-event right now. All right, one last attempt. that's not the official trial's motto, it needs to be. One more try. Oh, I just got the wrong angle. Oh, horrible there. Put it this way, I think the first time I get that second last obstacle smooth and clean on like my first attempt will probably be the first time I get this challenge. As you can see, I can kind of... stop that. I can do okay here. This part I struggle with, especially once I lose that first bit of momentum. God, I just want the Pit Viper. This is so easy. I'd already decided if I faltered then I was bailing off and going home. I am home, so I'm just going to bed. God, I hate making videos like this. I really do need to put that suicide prevention hotline down the bottom. Oh, that is just horrible. I'm done. That's how I feel about this whole challenge. That sucks. Anyway, that was my detailed tutorial and useless challenge video with regards to Top Roach. But guys, look, a stack of people have been asking for an update from me. I wanted to show a pretty genuine and sincere, this is kind of where I'm at. I am struggling with this. I'll be honest, I'd be lucky if I played this once a week as far as, you know, attempting this challenge. Maybe, I think probably since the first video, I've maybe only done it two or three times. Look, it sucks, it's horrible, I'm bad at it. But I'm consistently, you know, I can do under 10, under 5, okay. It will just be a matter of time before I nail it. So I'm confident that I'll get it. Hopefully you guys are too. Let me know in the comments where you're struggling, what you want me to focus on, if there's any techniques you want me to revisit, and maybe together we can kind of tackle this thing, because it's definitely, from all accounts, the hardest challenge in the game, and I'm very keen. It'd be actually nice to get this before the first DLC comes out. I think we've got 2 or 3 weeks before that happens, so... let me know in the comments what you think, anything you want me to revisit, let's go. I'm Fat Shady, whatever. This is a horrible video, but I'll finish up and get some sleep. Cheers, guys.